Welcome back. We all know the impact of working from home from a second year of lockdowns has been an emotional roller coaster, especially for Aussie employees. While many are enjoying flexible working arrangements, others are just burnt out. They're lonely. They're desperate to get back into the office.
A new nationwide study has revealed that women could be suffering more than men. And joining us to discuss is psychologist and founder of the Happiness Institute, Dr. Tim Sharp. Good morning to you, Tim. Thanks for your time. This report reveals feelings of loneliness were significantly higher among females, one in four saying they feel very isolated. What do you put that down to?
Yeah, look, firstly, thanks for having me. This is some really interesting research from LinkedIn, and I think it's shining some light on what we're all feeling at the moment. I think that finding about women feeling more lonely is just reinforces the fact that we know from other research that women tend to have more social connections. And so that in some ways, they're probably missing out. They're probably lost more than men in a way. So, it's something that we really need to pay attention to and hopefully address.
So 45% of men feel uncomfortable talking about their mental health at work, but only 24% of women felt the same way. Why that disparity?
Yeah, look, again, another really interesting research. Look, we've known for a long time that men and women are different when it comes to talking about mental ill health and reaching out and asking for help. When it comes to men, I'd love to see the numbers higher. The reason it's not probably comes down to stigma and what's sometimes referred to as toxic masculinity, that need to supposedly be strong and not show any weakness. I think when the reason that women are not feeling more comfortable is that maybe they feel their jobs are not as safe or secure. But look, either way, I think, we really need to keep working as we've been doing for a while now and helping more and more people feel more and more comfortable so they can get the help they need.
More than half of people say that having the option to work from home is actually good for their mental health. But for those who do feel a bit isolated, what can help? What can they do?
Yeah, look, I think one of the things this LinkedIn research has highlighted is that we're all different. So for some people, this has been a good thing. They've enjoyed it. For other people, it's been harder. What we can do is just pay attention and address the issues that go to our general health and well-being. So I think, as you can see on your screen, creating a structure and a routine can be really, really helpful. I think a lot of people have lost that in not going into the office. We can still stay connected, although, as many people have said, we need to physically distance. We don't necessarily need to socially distance. So we want to stay in touch to prioritise those friendships and use whatever technology we can to reach out and keep in touch with family, friends and colleagues. We still need to address our health and well-being by exercising. If you can get outside, particularly get out into some greenery, a park, that's been shown to be helpful as well. So, just do whatever you need to do for self-care so you can then function better.
We do know that we're going to be living with COVID for a long time now. Do you think that the way the workplace is seen, like more people are just happy working from home, will bosses and employers change the way we do things?
Well, I think they should. And I've been arguing for some of these things for a long time now, I think. I think we've seen, as someone that does a lot of work within workplaces, I think for too long there's been this focus on number of days in the office or number of hours at the desk. And that's patently absurd in some ways. I think we need to, and the research suggests we actually do better when we focus more on outcomes. And if people do it from home or from the office, then it doesn't really matter. Look, it'll differ for different people. Some people obviously need to be in the office. Some people need to interact more with others. But for those that can, if they feel better, if they're happier working from home and they're still productive, then why wouldn't we want more flexible workplaces? I think that's what the better employers are doing, and more will consider that as well.
Indeed.
This work from home culture is here to stay for many, isn't it? Tim, we really appreciate your time and your insights. Thanks so much for joining us.